everybody! I'm here today to tell you about some brake pedal secrets to make you brake much smoother. In this video, I will be going over a few specific brake pedal secrets. And if you use these secrets effectively, you will be able to brake smoother than you've ever been able to brake before. Without further ado, let's get right into the video. Secret number one is to plant your heel on the floor. Now, if you can imagine that this is the brake pedal over here, this right here, this fist is the brake pedal. If you have your foot and you're pushing the brake pedal like this, okay, so you're not planting your heel, then it's actually going to be hard for you to get a consistent amount of force. Because, I mean, we don't have like perfect robotic legs. We don't have like, we're not robots, we're human beings. So with that being said, our muscles, they move a little bit, they flex a little bit. So you might like be in and out a little bit. Whereas if you plant your heel on the floor, it's much easier, okay, to actually get a consistent amount of force and pressure like this. So if you can go like this, as opposed to going like this, if you can go like this, it's much easier. If you are, you know, moving your foot and your heel isn't on the floor, it's going to be hard to get consistent force. But when you plant your heel, you have that little leverage point and it's easier to brake smoother, okay? It'll just make for an overall smoother braking situation if you plant your heel. Secret number two is get to know your brake pedal power, okay? Now, this is especially true if you're driving a new car or if the car is new to you. Meaning if you buy a new car or you're driving someone else's car for the first, second, third, fourth, fifth time, you got to get to know the brake pedal power. Every car is going to respond differently. Right now, the vehicle that I'm driving, which is mine and my wife's Honda CR-V, has a totally different braking power and brake pedal response than our other car, which is a Mazda 3. Okay, it's very simple. You got to get to know the car that you're driving, and it'll allow you to brake much smoother if you know how much pressure to put forth on the brake pedal. Brake pedal secret number three is to practice braking distances in a parking lot. What I want you to do is go to an empty parking lot when there's no traffic and basically no cars in the parking lot. You know, there can be one or two cars, but you really want a massive difference. I would say go on a Sunday to a business parking lot that's only open Monday to Friday, because then like you're pretty much gonna guarantee that there's either no cars there or at least no one driving through there. I want you to pick a line in the parking lot and I want you to accelerate to a slow speed, let's say 10 kilometers an hour, and try and brake right at that line. Try and come to a complete stop right at that line. Then go back, accelerate to, let's say, 20 kilometers an hour, brake at that line, okay? 30 kilometers an hour, brake at that line. And then pick a different line, closer line, a further line. Pick all sorts of lines. And you want to basically just practice your braking distances, aka get to know, you know, your brake distances in an empty parking lot, because that's as safe as it can be. All right, if you have access to a closed driving course, then go for it. But most of the time, we're going to have to use empty parking lots. Brake pedal secret number four is brake earlier for a smoother stop. You see, the later that you brake, the harder that you're going to have to push the brake pedal. If I'm going 50 kilometers an hour, let's say I'm driving 50 kilometers an hour on a main road, and I have this much figurative distance to brake, I can brake much easier than if I only have this much distance to brake. So by braking earlier, you can actually push the brake pedal less, not as hard, or a little bit softer, which will create a smoother stop overall. The softer that you have to push the brake pedal, the smoother that the stop is going to be. So just brake like a fraction of a second earlier and keep doing that until you get the perfect braking distance and braking timeline. Brake pedal secret number five, the fifth brake pedal secret, is to avoid speeding up when you know that you're going to have to brake soon. We see this happening all the time on the road. People are driving, they floor it, then they have to hammer on their brakes. And that does not create for a smooth braking situation. If you know that you're going to have to brake in 3 seconds, then don't accelerate, just coast and then brake. Like if you know that you're going to have to brake all the way up there, you see there's tons of traffic on the road ahead. You know that you're going to have to come to a stop. Why would you accelerate only to come to a stop? That'll actually make you have to brake harder because you've sped up before you had to slow down. You got to brake harder, which will cause you to have a not so smooth braking situation. So if you want to brake much smoother, then read the road ahead, basically. If you know that you're going to have to slow down, avoid speeding up beforehand. Last but not least is the sixth brake pedal secret, and this is probably the most important one, okay? Because it will really create a smooth braking situation, and that's to use a consistent force on the brake pedal. So basically, your brake pedal, when you push it down, okay, you need a certain amount of force. If you're going like this with your foot, like you don't know what, how much to push it or how hard to push it, it's gonna be very, very difficult for you to brake smoothly, because you're gonna be like, your passengers are gonna be going like this, what's going on, what's going on, right? So you have to use a consistent amount of force. And in order to do that, you have to figure out how much force to use. And in order to do that, you need to practice. So practicing your braking by using all of these things, all of these secrets that I've spoken about in this video, sort of brings it all together into number six, which is to use consistent force. And you get to that by practicing. So if you bring all of these secrets sort of together, then they will allow you to use a consistent force on the brake pedal, which will allow you to brake smoother than ever before. Here's a little bonus tip, okay? If you want to see whether or not you're braking smooth, when you are braking or coming to a stop, watch your passengers, because your body is going to be prepared to react to your braking, because you're the one that's doing the braking. Plus, you have your hands on the wheel, okay? But if you look at your passenger in your, you know, passenger seat, the front passenger seat of your car, they're not going to be ready for your braking. So if they are like kind of just barely moving, that means you're doing a good job at braking smoothly. If you're braking and they're like, whoa, like flying around, if they're grabbing the wool bar, like, then obviously you have to practice more. It's as simple as that. And that's it. Those are some brake pedal secrets to make you brake much smoother. I really recommend that you use all of them and practice, because braking is probably the most important aspect of driving, because it keeps you safe. So I want you to brake better and I want you to brake smoother. And that's why I've outlined these secrets for you to use in this video. If you liked the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great car and driving videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.